trying, baby, trying to hold back this feeling for so long.
Hey, what's up, guys? So, welcome to another episode of Angelic Sounds. My name is Angel. So today it's gonna be a little different. So, like I said, I'm a piano and a voice teacher. So today we're gonna start looking at scales. Alrighty. So scales are very important for us as musicians because a lot of the passages, a lot of the stuff that we do in music has those connecting lines from point A to point B. And it's really important for us to know how to get there correctly, okay? Usually, most of the time when we're playing scales or runs, we're just doing it for practice and to get good with our velocity, practicing different tempos. I don't know, I have a lot of my students that they see when I play the piano that I just do. They ask me, hey, do I need to play that fast? And I'm like, no, you just have to get used to it. And usually most of the time you're playing scales just to warm up for your actual repertoire. So I decided might as well today start learning a little bit of scale. So we're gonna start with the C major scale. Alrighty, so what we're gonna do is that we're gonna just start our C major scale starting on C. And what we're going to do is going to be a five relay type of relationship. It's a 5 and 3 relationship. So it's always going to be either 3, then 5, or 5, then 3. So for the left hand, what's going to happen is that we're going to start first with a 5. So 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 3. 2, 1. Okay? So let me do that one more time. So it's gonna be 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. Always remembering that your 1 is gonna be your thumb, your 2 is gonna be your index, your 3 is gonna be your middle, 4 is gonna be your ring, 5 is gonna be your pinky. Okay? So let's do that one more time. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 3, 2, 1. Alrighty, now let's go to the right hand. So the right hand is going to look like this. It's going to be, again, three group of threes. 1, 2, 3. And then the way you're going to be crossing, I didn't address this with the left hand, but the way you cross is that for the left hand, if you're going up, for example, here, my middle finger is going to go across to the A over, okay? With the right hand, when we're going up, when you cross with your thumb, because we're going to cross with our thumb, it's going to be under, all right? So it's going to be C, D, E, under to F, okay? So let's do that one more time. So C, D, E, F, right? All right, so let's do the both hands right now. Let me see, okay, I think you guys can see most of my left hand. So, let me try. So, alright, so now, coming back down, when you're coming back down with the left hand, it's gonna be again the group of threes. So, C, B, A. And the same way you were under, you went under with the right hand, you're gonna come under like that to the G. So let's try that one more time. C, C, B, A, G, F, E, D, C. So cross. And make sure you're having, you're using all of your fingers with both things. Alright, so with the right hand one more time, and then going up, and then coming back down, you're gonna cross over, just like we did with the left hand. So, up, cross under, over, Left hand, over, under. All right? Every single time we do this, I always tell my students that they can try first with the right hand, and then try with the left hand. So now that they have a sense of what it feels with both hands and that they feel comfortable playing with both hands separately, now I tell them to play them together, okay? So one thing to be always on the lookout for is that when you're playing these scales, eventually it's gonna get to a point where you're crossing with one hand and your other hand it keeps going, okay? So you but gotta make sure you're watching your fingers, all right? So, for example, when you're playing with both hands at the very beginning, you cross first with the right hand and then you keep going with the left. So, and then with the left and with the right, you're gonna be doing this. So, you gotta make sure when you're doing that, that you always remind yourself that, okay, here's where I'm playing with my thumb and with my index. Now, a good way to remember if you're playing the right notes with the right fingers is having some pivot notes, all right? So our pivot note here, it's gonna be E, and if I'm not mistaken, A, all right? So it's gonna be E and A. Why is this gonna be our pivot notes? Because when we play these two notes, we're gonna be playing them with our threes, all right? Our third finger, our middle finger, is gonna be playing that note, and you should be playing that note with both hands with the same finger. So for example here, I play with my middle finger and then I cross with the right and then I cross with the left and then I'm playing, you can't see it right now, but I'm playing with both fingers on A, then B, C, right? So one more time, so E together, cross with the right, cross with the left, and then I'm playing A's together, B, C, alright? This is very simple. From here on, it just gets easier, because most of the white keys, when you play them, they have the same fingering. Now there are a few that do change, for example, F and B. We can talk about it in another video, but as in right now, this is what this is. It's not too hard to understand. Another thing that you could do is that as you play the notes, you can sing the notes. So that's one way to incorporate your singing into your piano playing. It's by singing the scales that you're playing. So, for example, if it was me, I would start here on C. C is gonna be, for this example, it's gonna be Do. D is gonna be Re. E is gonna be Mi. F is gonna be Fa. G is gonna be Sol. A is gonna be La. B is gonna be T. And C is gonna be Do again. So, Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti, Do. Let me say that one more time. Without the notes. Do, Re, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti, Do. Alright? So, how is this gonna help us? You can take that Do to Do and transpose it to any key you want. So this is what we call movable Do in this type of scenario. So the way you do this is that you take, for example, the first note in your scale and you call that your Do. And then if you go to a different scale, you could call that as well Do and might as well sing it in tune. Why? Because if you sing this as you play it, you're going to have that harmonic and melodic understanding of what's going on in the piano. So for example, if I were to tell you that from Fa to Mi, there's a half step, and from T to Do, there's another half step. You can do the same thing in a different key. For example, D major. This is my Do. Re, Mi, Fa. You remember how I said from Mi to Fa, there's a half step? Now you can do the same thing from T to Do. Alright? Alrighty? So, Fa to Mi, T to Do, half step relationship. Everything else, as in right now, it's going to be whole step, half step, whole step, whole step, whole step, half step. Alrighty? Let's go back to C major. So, what you can do right now is play the note, find it in your own voice. So sometimes it's hard to match pitch, but what you could do is slide into it. So for example, if it was me, if I was about to sing this Do, I could do Do, Do. Okay, so once you find the note, try to find it without the sliding. So you try to do Do, Do, and make sure you have it secure. Now, next one. Re, Mi, sorry, Mi, Fa, Sol, La, Ti, Do. All right? And like with our scales, when we get to the top, let's go back down. So, Do, Ti, La, Sol, Fa, Mi, Re, Do. Alrighty? If you do this, you're gonna get a lot better with your singing, and you're gonna get a lot better with your scales, and everything just works together at this point. You can start working with exercises for your own singing, like that, and stuff like that. I mean, it just having that relationship between knowing what note is gonna be your Do, what note is gonna be your Sol, what note is gonna be your Mi, and stuff like that. It helps you a lot when you're singing and having that interval relationship, that half step, whole step relationship, and everything is just gonna start to make more sense. Alrighty? Alright, so those were the C major scale. If you guys have any questions, just let me know. It's very useful to know all these things. It just makes you a better and more rounded musician to have all of these things down before you start to go into actual repertoire. So if you guys have any questions about it, and if you guys feel like I didn't explain as much as I could, just let me know in the comments. Let's love, baby.